Okay, Shalom, Shalom, Kwame Sha'Allah, Koholoyimla, Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh, Bahashim Rahakodash. Double honors to our apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well, and that by the Spirit taught us this beautiful truth. And just want to say Pawada to all the Akim and Ahwaf that's out here sincerely keeping the laws, the statutes, and commandments of Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh, to the best of their ability. This is Yahanan the Waf, just coming at you with another quick lesson and praying that it's edifying by the Spirit. And, somebody entitled this, and this is for educational purposes only, bro, but they entitled it Women in 2024. It says, watch me frame my underwear at a bar. And hey, this is your average woman, man, in America, man. This is the mindset and the attitude that they have. They go out, they get, you know, sloppy fucking fucked up, drunk, whether it's drugs, a sniff, a pill, whatever they own. And they, you know, and they have men, you know, they'll tell you that, you know, they're innocent, you know, all these things about how good they are and how they're the prize. And, but this is what they're, this is the overall what you're getting, man, when you dealing with these women, man. So, you know, the apostles always go up into, hey, watch the women, man, watch who you dealing with, man, and don't get married to these women. Why would you go and allow the so-called white man to be in your business? Shit, man, this lady, a chick like this will take you back and forth to court forever, man. She'll drain your pockets. You fuck around and have kids with her, you're going to be through. But anyway, let's play the video, man. You'll see, and it's disgusting, too, at that.
They're at a bar.
I'm telling you right now.
See this bitch, man? This is your average. They got the perfect title, Women in 2024. And somebody actually filming her. You don't think somebody else seen the video, chick? You don't think that your friends showed this to everybody? How you think it's online? How you think I'm able to see it? Just bad with judgment, you know? But let's play some more. But matter of fact, you know what? Let me get something real quick. Okay, let's get the law right here. Leviticus 15 and 19, it says, and if a woman have an issue, and her issue is in her flesh be blood, she shall be put apart 7 days. And whosoever toucheth her shall be unclean until the evening. See? She's supposed to be somewhere away from people, man. Here you go. She's all at the bar. She's at the bar, man, chopping it. Let me see, so let's go into this real quick. Let's read it in the NLT. New Living Translation says, whenever a woman has her menstrual period, she will be ceremonial unclean for 7 days. Anyone who touches her during that time will be unclean until evening. See? So she's supposed to be, you know, but this was the ancient days, man. This is a long ways away from the ancient days right here, boy. Look at this shit. Disgusting, bro. And she'll be what they would call a baddie. You know? Just disgusting. Bird brains. No damn sense at all. She says, we bleed through everything. This is disgusting, bro. But this is America, man. You can't say that this is not Babylon the Great. You can't say that this is not Babylon the Great, bro.
Oh, stop. Nicole. Stop. Oh, it's not close. Wait, where's the thing on?
No, it needs to stay.
Wait, is there? I have that shot.
So, hey, this is your girl when she goes out on girl nights, man. This is your girl when she's talking about, we're going to, you know, me and my girlfriends, we're going to Mexico or wherever the fuck. This is them. This is what they're doing when they're away from you. So, don't be surprised. But let's go off into the Apocrypha real quick, man. I seen this like, ugh. Ugh. Hey, we need out of here, man. And see, when Isaiah 4 and 1, matter of fact, you know what, let's get that real quick. When Isaiah 4 and 1 kick in, the Lord is going to do something so drastically terrible in the earth, man, that these women are going to come flocking to the men of the Lord, man. In a minute, the Lord gonna have that discernment to eyeball a bitch like this right here. Like, nope, I don't, get away. Straight up, get away. Let's lock you. Yeah, so lock you for the noise too. I'm out here, neighbor. He's out here cutting the grass and stuff. Isaiah 4:1. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name to take away our reproach. Now, how do you think these selfish ass women in America, you really think that could happen now while they're in their glory? Nah, man, the Lord is going to make some real treacherous shit happen where they're going to be so afraid. First off, it ain't going to be no more bars to go to hang your panties up. You're not going to even want to be out in public when in the days that's going to come in that time. See? So it's about to get grimy out here. and again, these are the women that niggas be simping over, bro. That'll go all out of his wits to do whatever for it, man. Not even worth it. Can't let the cutie pie get you, man. Don't let the scriptures talk about that too. On the beauty of a woman. Let's go to man, you can almost read all of Ecclesiastes 25. But let's see here. Let's see where we can whew, my goodness gracious. Yep, verse 13. Let's start here. Give me any plague but the plague of the heart, and any wickedness but the wickedness of a woman. Good googly goo, bro. There is no head above the head of the of a serpent, and there is no wrath above the wrath of an enemy. I had and imagine having your woman as an enemy, man. And that's pretty much what Esau has done in his kingdom too. He has turned a woman into a complete weapon against the men, man. And that goes for every nationality, but mainly the Israelites, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. It says, verse 16, I had rather dwell with a lion and a dragon than to keep house with a wicked woman. Which means, man, you should stay away from this bitch like the plague, man. The wickedness of a woman changes her face and darkeneth her countenance like sackcloth. Her husband shall sit among the neighbors, and when he heareth it, shall sigh bitterly. All wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. Let the portion of a sinner fall upon her. Woo. As the climbing up a sandy way is to the feet of the age, so is a wife full of words to a quiet man. Stumble, this is the one that I wanted to get. Stumble not at the beauty of a woman, and desire her not for pleasure. Because she wasn't a bad looking chick. You can clearly see those panties that's up on the wall. You know the type of chicks that wear shit like that. They're generally some okay looking chicks. You know what I'm saying? Some of them be, you know, have a real nice beauty. But the wickedness of a heart, man, it's like, that's where you got to just be like, ah, no thank you. Verse 24, of the woman came the beginning of sin, and through her we all die. Verse 25, give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty to gad abroad. See, she's wicked as hell, and she has that liberty to gad abroad, and look at what she's doing. Look at what you're doing. You're out in public, in a public bathroom, taking off your drawers with your stains in them. You clearly said we bleed through everything. And then you hang them nasty shits up on a wall, man, in a bathroom, and that's probably a nice what they would consider to be a nice bar. One of those ones, you know what I'm saying, where the drinks cost you astronomical prices. You know the ones. The one, you know, where the women just, they got to go out. It's just the thought of, I got to be seen. Look at how pretty and nice this place is. Let me take some selfies. Just going out, just spending an exorbitant amount of money for nothing. Just to be looking, just to look, you know, just for a couple of seconds of pleasure, man. Verse 25, give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty to gad abroad. Hey, I mean, and then you can go into chapter 26. The whoredom on verse 9, Ecclesiasticus 26 and 9, the whoredom of a woman may be known in her haughty looks and eyelids. If thy daughter be shameless, keep her in straitly, lest she abuse herself through overmuch liberty. This is overmuch liberty right here. She's abusing herself. Why would you, you know, here, because you say, like, for instance, you got this Republican Democrat shit going on right now. Hey, if she was to ever get into politics, somebody gonna pull that video. That video is not going nowhere. She'll try and scrub it, try and hide it, try and, one of her friends in the backdrop will have that video forever. Vindictive ass boyfriend. Why? How you think it's online? How you think we able to see it right now? Watch over an impudent eye and marvel not if she trespass against thee. Hey, you can't marvel, man. We're not tripping on women when they do shit, man. When you come into this truth, you're gonna just see and know. You should anyway. One of the main enemies that's gonna be one of your enemies in this truth could be your woman, man, your spouse. Like, for real. Verse 3, let me see. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's get all. We got to get all this here. It says, watch over an impudent eye and marvel not if she trespass against thee. She will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler when he hath found a fountain and drink of every water near her. By every hedge will she sit down and open her quiver against every arrow. See? And that's true. And they be out here acting like, you know, generally, if you speaking to them in public, I guess, you know, sometimes they'll give you an Instagram or they might pass you off the number. But a lot of these chicks, they meeting a lot of these dudes online on these apps and shit like that, man. They'll hook up with them, man, to do the thing and then act as if they ain't done nothing. They still sweet. They still innocent. With that sweet girl, you know, hey, what? Come on, man. Motherfucker, a slip out the window on you at night and wake up and make her parents be back in the window before it's time to get up and make her parents breakfast, man. Easy. Verse 13, the grace of a wife delighteth her husband, and her discretion will fat his bones. Ain't no discretion here. No discretion going on here. A silent and loving woman is a gift of the Lord, and there is nothing so much worth as a mind well instructed. A shamefast and faithful woman is a double grace, and her continent mind cannot be valued. And that's a rarity these days, man. It's really rare, especially in the Americans. The Americas, man, you can forget about it. It's a wrap for that. Verse 23, a wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man, but a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. A dishonest woman contemneth shame, but an honest woman will reverence her husband. A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog, but she that is shamefaced, will fear the Lord. See? A shameless woman shall be, this lady is a dog, man. She's a dog. She's just a pretty decent looking dog. Look at her. That shit is retarded. On your monthly. Disgusting, bro. Anyway, I'm going to end out, man. I ain't want to keep it too long. I just wanted to go off into, I seen that. I'm like, God damn, boy. And somebody, they entitled it perfectly. Women in 2024. But what they should have put was Women of America, Babylon the Great. And it's being passed on to all the other nations as well. The other nations, they like that too now. Your Arab woman with the head wrap, she's nasty too. Your Jewish woman, you know, that supposedly keep the Sabbath, she nasty too. They all that Babylon juice, man, is everywhere. The Chinese woman, the Japanese woman, you name it. And they generally, you know, get their pretty much, I'll put it this way, the so-called black woman, she's pretty much the mascot of this shit. You know? I think I really got to say, yo, our people, Israelites, the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, yeah, we got it the worst. I'm not going to front on that there, but these other women, they done drunk of that Babylonian juice, too. They want some of that, They want some of that too. Why you think those women over there in Afghanistan and all those different areas are fighting to take off those hijabs and shit, if I'm pronouncing it right? They don't want to be covered no more. See, when America was over there and gave them that democracy for about 20 years, they got used to being, you know, sliding off into the American way. So when the Taliban came back through and was like, hey, a matter of fact, I seen an article yesterday where they asses is not even able to even speak in public. They're not even able to even speak. Shut the fuck up. But see, in America, they'll call that barbaric. You know, how demonic are they? They're cavemen. No, they got order. That's the order, man. Well, here you go, America calling themselves a Christian nation. You don't have no order whatsoever. The women are all out of control. It's little girls out here. Or we would call them little girls, man. These motherfuckers, man, they know, they listening to their mama and their aunties, so they already know game. The aunties and mama and grandmama and them don't have no discretion. I remember back in the days, hey, you got the fuck out of the room when grown folks speak. Man, they be talking all kinds of shit around these what you would call kids. Matter of fact, be giving them advice on how to be, you know what I'm saying, as they grow up and wearing these tight ass clothes, man. So, I mean, it is what it is. So when that Isaiah 4:1 comes about, it's going to have to be, I can't even imagine. That's why it talks about how it's going to be like no time that has ever been in the earth, so to speak, roughly paraphrasing. Because it's going to have to be something really fucking terrible to make 7 of these selfish ass women want to take hold of one man. It's got to be something real. They on top right now. They winning. They winning. You here in America, you can have a chick with 6 different baby daddies, man, and she can still pull a simp. She can still pull a simp that'll take care of all them motherfuckers, man, and take care of all her bills. So there's going to come a point where the Lord is going to make things happen so bad that they're going to be like, up. And first off, again, too, the scriptures talks about how, trying to think, is that 2nd Ezra 15 or is it 16, where it talks about how these men are going to go to war. And it's not going to be a lot of men around, basically, too. A lot of men are going to be in prison. A lot of them are, you know, into the alphabet shit. And then you're going to have those ones that when they do the conscription or they get the drafting these clowns. And they're going to draft some of you panty planners too. You just wait until that they hit her ass with that drive, bro. She going to be boo-hooing. I bet you that'll sober her ass up. But yeah, man, it's going to be something that's going to come along because these women are out of control. I'm talking about on every level of violence, man. Look at this one. Girl, favorite thing is to dance. Wait for the surprise. My boyfriend told me my clothes are too revealing. See, this type of shit right here. So these types of women right here, they gone, man. But these types of women right here, the Lord going to break their asses all the way down. And all. And it's gonna be some humbleness coming back into this earth, man, from you women. Y'all going to get y'all asses back in order. Nope, here you go right here. Missing teen Sophia Barker getting coffee is rushed to the hospital after being found by Hero Guard. See? 17. How you get snatched up, girl? How long was you gone? Yep, she was in New York around Wall Street area. And that's a busy area. How the fuck you get getting coffee? Who you see? And they ain't playing no games. She had last been seen around 10:30 a.m. The teenager was then found by a security guard at Seward Park Liberty Library. I don't know. This heroic guard recognized Barker from an information bulletin. He called the local police, who immediately came to the library. The teenager was then rushed to the hospital. Called Barker's stepfather and then FaceTimed him to confirm her identity. Barker's family explained they were worried about the teen as she seemed to have missed at least one dose of her medication. Come on, bro. And that's what y'all talking about. I thought she was snatched up, her ass at the park. Yeah, this type of man, all this shit. If she can pick him up, I don't need her. And look how she dressed. Out in public like this. So just think, I'm telling you, man, it's about to get nasty out here. This is just your regular thing. And it's so regular. It's like, you know who this anyway. Here you go with one of Ice Spice. Give me a light. Look at her. This is your generation of American women, man. Why would you marry something like this? Why would you wife something like this up, man? It's only gonna be a problem. You ain't getting nothing good out of nothing like that, though. You might get a you know, of course you're gonna, you know, flesh wise, lust wise. You know, yeah, you'll be good for a little bit. But other than that, some talking about some future. Hell no, nah, you out your mind. You're playing yourself. You were playing yourself. Holly Berry, 58, deemed hottest woman alive. She's still out here trying to. All these older women too. That's crazy because they got a they got what they call a grandma. What is they calling it? Pretty much, you know, I guess they getting little BBLs and little, but I it's something for women over 60, 70s or something like that. Grandma's plastic surgery or some shit like that. So a lot of these grandmamas trying to bring that old thing back and with all them miles on it. Got all them miles on that box and trying to bring that thing back, boy. But that's the days that you're living in. And they're supposed to be raising the young women to be good wives to their husbands and, you know, good mothers to their children, roughly paraphrasing, I think, in Titus. You know, teaching them how to, you know, keep house and do the, you know, just keep the family up. Nope, you crazy, bro. Yeah. Yeah, it's video after video after video, story after story after story on this bad boy. News break done got a little cold with it. They going straight hardcore, man. These videos they be having on here is violent, sexualized, and it's just, yeah, it's just, a lot going on, man, in the world. But it do show how close we are, man, to getting the hell out of here because it's all flood behavior. And just like the days of Noah, just like the days of Lot, this is all flood behavior, man. It ain't getting no better neither. It's only going to get worse. But I can't wait, man, to see, you know, when that Isaiah 4:1 kick in. You know, I'm sure it's going to be some brutal times for both sexes. It's going to be brutal for everybody. But, man, for a woman, there's going to come a point where she ain't going to handle goddamn tampon. You just going to be out here smelly. There's about to be some bad times coming into the earth, man. You know, all that comfortability that you have, these little things that you go through on a day-to-day basis, worrying about rent, worrying about a car note, worrying about this, or, you know, having to go have surgery or whatever the fuck. That ain't going to be nothing, man, when it straight comes down to it, man, when the Lord starts to let go of these things in the earth, man. So I pray that the lesson was edifying. With that, I pray that the lesson was edifying. Kwame Yashala, the Bible Ball, man. We can't wait.